Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny, and I'm talking about dissolving lip filler. It's often asked question, and or people comment on YouTube and they do their videos, I dissolve my lip filler. I want my lip filler dissolved. So I thought we'd talk about that a little bit today, and we're gonna talk about the why, the when, and finally the how. Let's go through the why first. Why would you ever dissolve your lip filler? There's a few reasons. Number one, over time, this is probably one of the most common that we see, and we dissolve lip filler every week or two for people. People have been getting lip filler now since, well, restylane came in 2003 in this country, in the United States, but it was around the globe prior to that. So people have been getting lip filler for 15 to 20 years with hyaluronic acids. It builds up over time. It wears off in an irregular pattern, possibly. Also, some products came to market that draw a lot of water in. So people then get a sausagey looking lip. And we might look at that when patients walk in and say, you know what? We're gonna dissolve that and start over. Very, very common. No fault of anyone's, but it's a normal thing that occurs over time. So it might be because of lip filler over time. Another reason might be lumps and bumps, and it just happens. Some people get them with certain products. Some people get them from bad luck. Some people get them from injector error. There's many, many reasons. Also, if there's any scar tissue in the lip, the filler's gonna wanna migrate to one area. The beautiful thing is, if you're getting a hyaluronic acid filler, which is the most popular product used around the world, then you can dissolve certain areas. So that's another reason. A third reason would be style. Simply, say someone gets a lip that's bigger on the top than the bottom and they want to change it up. We now have the ability to do these things. There's nothing wrong with that. If people want to change the style, if they had a wide mouth because we added more laterally, they may now want a narrower look. They may want more central. They may have a central tubercle that was big and now they don't want it. So that's another reason. And then there are emergent reasons why we might dissolve it. So when do you dissolve your lip filler? This is important because take away any emergent situations. A lot of people will call back hours after, and of course there'll be swelling. There can be lumps and bumps. There can be irregularities. And yes, people will know that you look different. So if your friends or family are mocking you or making fun, and that's the problem, dissolving it that soon after, you can't just dissolve a little bit to take the edge off and then no one will know. And you get lip filler, give yourself a week or two of grace period to look perfect. And so when do you do it? Take away emergent situations. At about 2 weeks, we always say, is when it settles in the way it's gonna be, incorporates with the tissue. Certainly ask your provider, they'll guide you along the way. It's okay to call it 2 hours, but you may not wanna dissolve it right then, and it changes the consistency of the product. Now we'll go to how we do it. And we have the reverser and enzyme. Most people use Hylenex. There's a recombinant form, and then of course there's an animal-based form that we used before that we used to have to skin test for. We have a whole video on dissolving products, and that applies to lip filler that's hyaluronic acid. And remember, know where you go, because you wanna get the product that you pay for. Some people do put silicone, PMMA, some people even use calcium in lips, and there are implants, so know what you're getting, but the majority of people ask for and do get dissolvable fillers. So that's all about lip fillers and dissolving them. If you have any questions below or comments, what's your experience? We'd love to hear about it. Join us and subscribe to this channel for helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.